This is the third in a series of 8 chemistry labs on the fundamentals of biodiesel. In this lab, we will learn about determination of the acid number of vegetable oils by titration. Written procedures and background information for all 8 labs is provided on the Biodiesel Education website. To make biodiesel, fats and oils, or triglycerides, react with a catalyst and an alcohol to produce ethyl esters, or biodiesel, and glycerin. However, if you are making biodiesel using waste vegetable oil or fat, those triglycerides may be degraded and have a lot of free fatty acids not attached to a glycerol backbone. These free fatty acids can react with the catalyst first to create soap, which must be removed. Therefore, before making biodiesel, it is necessary to determine the amount of free fatty acids in the oil or fat in order to properly adjust the chemical process. In this laboratory exercise, we are going to determine the amount of free fatty acids that are present in a waste vegetable oil sample. The measurement of the amount of free fatty acids is called acid number and is done by titration. The acid number is a measure of acidity and is expressed as the quantity of a known concentration of potassium hydroxide, or KOH, consumed by titrating 1 gram of a sample in the units of milligrams, mg, of KOH per gram of sample. Titration is a common laboratory method where a solution of known concentration is used to determine the concentration of an unknown solution. To conduct this exercise, you will need titration equipment and a weighing scale. Note that in this lab, the instructor will prepare the solutions, but know that these solutions are highly flammable and can burn skin and harm eyes. You must wear gloves, a lab coat or apron, and eye protection. The strategy for this laboratory exercise is to do 3 titrations. 2 of the titrations will be vegetable oil samples, and 1 will be for the blank, or reference. The blank is the titration solution made by the instructor, and is a known concentration which is added, titrated, to another solution to determine the concentration of a second chemical species. The acid number determined for the vegetable oil will be the average of the acid number obtained from the 2 vegetable oil samples. If your instructor has not provided you with a raw data table, prepare a raw data table like the one shown here in your notebook. The first step is to weigh an empty flask and record the weight on the raw data table. Then weigh approximately 1 gram of oil sample to the nearest 1/100th of a gram and transfer to the titration flask. Record the actual sample volume in data table. Add 125 milliliters of titration solvent into the flask containing the sample. Add a couple of drops of phenolphthalein indicator into the solution. Swirl the solution vigorously for approximately 1 minute to ensure the uniformity of the solution. Prepare the second vegetable oil sample for titration by repeating these steps. Then prepare a blank reference with only titration solvent and phenolphthalein indicator and no oil by again repeating the previous steps. Fill the burette with a titration solution. Record the starting volume of titrant on the data table. Carefully introduce the titrant from the burette into the flask while swirling the solution vigorously, but without spattering. Stop inducing titrant when the solution changes color to pink. Record the ending volume of titrant on the data table. Repeat the process for the second sample and the blank. Once the 3 titrations have been completed and the data recorded, calculate the acid number for the 2 samples. The acid number from both samples should be about the same. If not, another titration is recommended. Otherwise, add the numbers and divide by 2 for the average acid number. Thank you for watching the Determination of Acid Number of Vegetable Oils by Titration Lab on the Fundamentals of Biodiesel. Please go to the Biodiesel Education website for a complete written transcript of this lab exercise.